Today, I am finally graduating college. I went to college for 3 years where COVID existed for two of them. I still remember rolling up my freshman year with big goals and aspirations, being crammed in a tiny dorm room with my best friend where we didn't even have an AC unit. We were thrown into a new town and told to make friends, making every moment count. So many memories from my freshman year living in that dorm. Then, in the middle of it, we were told to pack up our bags, go home, and stay inside the house.
COVID now rising to the highest point.
The coronavirus outbreak.
COVID-19 outbreak.
Now, this actually changed college for everyone. Everything had switched to online, and I had never seen campus this dead before. But this year was my sophomore year where I was living in the house and created some of the funniest memories. From buying 4 baby ducks, to traveling all over across the country. Now this was actually a once in a lifetime opportunity. School being online allowed me to have so much more free time to just film and hang out with friends. Then transitioning into this year, my final and senior year of college. I had been waiting for this moment my whole life. Finally, I would graduate college and have the freedom to focus on my dream of filmmaking. And that's what I did. Throughout this year, I had the opportunity to work with some amazing people. Artists like Made in Tokyo and Uno the Activist. Athletes like Jared McCain and Patrick Wea. I was able to fulfill my dream of filmmaking while attending school. Which all leads to this moment. The day where I finally will never have to take another test, never have to sit inside of a classroom, and the day I get to walk across stage. Let me take you through that day. All right, so right now, we're gonna do some senior photos just to get them out the way. You know,
had to get a little dripped out. Okay.
Look at how big it is.
Whoa, like, that's the pastor.
Is it supposed to be this big?
Wow. That should look nice.
Now, imagine I just go up there, I sat down the whole time, and
you
they like,
a different name.
They don't even call my name. I just stay sitting.
We actually forgot one. Like, who is it? Oh, Xavier.
What happened?
What happened? What happened? I'm
gonna have some dripped out.
Put some diamonds on the end.
Hey, bro, check this one out, bro. Real cool.
Wow, bro.
Participation award only.
Wow, imagine.
Look, whoa, the fish says come on it.
That's how you know you're not smiling.
This says come?
Look at it.
You'll see the photos posted right here. She moved out of state, she didn't want to left, she's seeking forgiveness. She used to dance, but she went alone, started a business. But daddy was not around, my mama was not around. I watched her climb on the top of the pole, and then it's sliding down. I make it rain in this bitch, I make it snow in this bitch. Trying to get out of the bitch. Shawty was going legit, Shawty was going legit. Well, we got the great bell right here.
That's Paul Blart.
Wow. Watch out,
G. Wow.
Oh, shit.
Whoa.
No way the metal broke.
That boy coming in hot, goddammit.
Is this Virgil?
Yeah.
Is this
Virgil?
We on the music.
Alright, so I went to Mankato for 3 years. First year, I lived in the dorms. Second year, I lived in 118. And third year, I lived in U Square. But now, I'm about to go revisit my old dorm room. Let's go.
For those of y'all that went to Mankato, y'all know about the greatest hall, Crawford.
Where you get no AC, you barely get heat, and it's just old. But it is the OG spot where we did get our first dorm room. On the way to Crawford, you got the OG eat spot. You gotta get your meal at Chet's.
The kids done got in.
We stuck in. This is the basement down here, bro. Everything goes. I don't even know what's down there, truthfully. I have not walked up these stairs in so long. As you know, COVID happened our freshman year, so we got kicked out halfway.
But we threw so much shit down this hallway too.
So many times.
Oh! All right, so we went to the dorm room, but they weren't there. because I think everybody moved out like last week during like finals, but we still got a photo in front of it, which is dope. After this, I don't even know what we're about to do. Let's just see what we get into. It might just be tomorrow at graduation, but let's go.
Look who made it.
Damn, G. Yeah. That boy was an undercover cop for the night. Here we got like 10 more minutes. The kid Gabe is about to fucking graduate. Let's fucking go! Woo!
Put my shirt off. I'm gonna be in that bitch. Man, woo!
Hey, man.
My son finally grew up.
Yeah, I got a message for him.
I got a... Gabe, I'm so proud of you, honey. Look what you've done. 3 years? What you do is amazing to me, Gabe. I'm so proud of you. Thank you.
I'ma cry.
But I love you, G. I love you.
That's my boy. Since age 4, we went to daycare with each other. All time. OG.
You pray for my demons, girl, I got you. Every time I sip on codeine, I get vulnerable. Annoying the sounds of the storm when it comes. She understand I can't take her everywhere a nigga going. I've been in the field like the children of the corn. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at yourself cause you can't leave me alone. Gossip, get messy, it ain't what we doing.
I just get so emotional, man. I just say
woo!
Yeah! Yeah! And he got the
peep, peep the shoes, the Space Jams. The Space Jams. Yeah. The Space Jams.
Just stop. Hold
on. Gabriel Mesfin.
Yeah! That's my brother!
Over the phone, drop it too. I get more vulnerable than you feel. When you drunk, you tell me exactly how you feel.
Three years ago, this was me. My first ever day of college. I still remember the first time stepping foot on campus. A shy, scared 18-year-old who didn't know what he was getting himself into. But that's honestly what excited me, the unknown. People told me tips before going to college like, go out and meet people, make sure you have shower shoes, leave your door open on the first day, and this will be the greatest years of your life. Well, which some of this advice was helpful. I realized how interesting an opportunity that college was, really bringing thousands of young adults together in one space and telling them, go experience life. In Mankato, I met so many dope people. Honestly, I would have never expected this experience to be like this. If I were to go back to my freshman year self and tell him what was about to happen in these 3 years, I probably wouldn't believe it. From my first night sleeping in the dorms, my first meal in the dining hall, and attending my first class, college was such a cool experience. All these memories lead to this moment. The day I'm finally going to be done with college and say goodbye to Mankato. Honestly, this is a bittersweet moment. College was a crazy experience that I will never forget. I will never forget all those memories and friends that I've made here. I can't wait to see what the future holds. Thank you, Mankato.